All right, today we're going to be looking at OpenRA. OpenRA is an open source engine made for playing classic real-time strategy titles, specifically Red Alert, but also now other titles. So let's take a bit of a history lesson here to understand what we're talking about. In 1995, Westwood Studios released the original Command & Conquer title, and that was followed up in 1996 with Red Alert as a sequel slash prequel to the original title. Red Alert got some expansion packs along the way, and then it was ported to the PlayStation, and there's some extra content added at that point. Westwood Studios was bought by EA, and in 2000, EA released Command & Conquer Remastered Collection, which is a high-definition remaster of the original Command & Conquer and Red Alert, along with the expansion packs for both of those. At the same time, they released the source code for Red Alert as open source. However, open source projects had already begun at that point. OpenRA already existed and was freeware, like an open source rather, engine, as I said, that was made to play the original game files for Red Alert. It's expanded, as I mentioned, playing other titles, notably Dune 2000. It's going to be the best way to play that. And there's been some spin-off projects of it, some upcoming standalone mods, and even standalone Steam titles based on OpenRA. So I'm looking forward to covering those. Earlier this year, EA released the Command & Conquer Ultimate Collection onto Steam, releasing a lot of these titles for the first time onto Steam. And this is $20 and goes on sale from there even. And this can be the best way to pick up a lot of these titles. But at the time, there was not support in OpenRA for this Steam collection. You had to jump through a bit of hoops and install it from the get directly. So I decided not to make a video at that point. But today, there is an update available for OpenRA, adding a lot of new features, new map editor, new in-game encyclopedia, and game assets can now be installed directly from the Steam release of Ultimate Collection. So that's going to be relevant for a lot of people who picked up the Ultimate Collection. Now we're going to be able to install this open source engine with tons of modern features for real-time strategy games and support for other games. It's a pretty exciting project to see what they're doing there in the open source world. So we're going to install this today. We're also going to see if we can't get the assets from the remastered collection working. I have that installed on Steam as well. So we'll see what we can get here off of this. So we're going to go to the download page. The stable release is still last year's release from 2023. We're going to be looking at this new release from 2024 that may change in the future. You may get a new stable release in the future with these features we're looking for here. So we're going to run this here. New install file. Under the new public license, so free for non-commercial. This is the playtest, so it's installing separately from the stable version. All right, that's completed there and installed here in our program files / OpenRA playtest. And we have a few. Few executables here. Red Alert here. Manage content. Yeah, so it's all automatically picking up base game files or expansions, picking up everything here. Yeah. Off of both. Yeah. Very great. So that confirms we got our, oh, this is our options of where it can detect from. So it's detecting at least one of our installs there, probably our ultimate collection. So that's great. No effort required there. Got Allied campaign, Soviet campaign, Counter-Strike expansion, Aftermath expansion, some OpenRA originals, and the Ant missions, which were original to the PlayStation version. We've got videos here. So I think these are the original low quality videos here. We'll see if we can't get the HD assets working as well.
Commander, the last transmission? 0900 hours since.
We got multiplayer servers running. Red Alert, Tiberian Dawn, and Dune 2000. Okay, from what I can tell, the Tiberian Dawn HD project here will allow HD assets from the original Command & Conquer title to be used in the OpenRA platform there as well. So we should be already using our HD assets when available for Red Alert. So the Tiberian Dawn is also available in the base OpenRA package. We also have Dune 2000 available here, which I do not have installed. We'll do the quick install. This content is also available freely as well. So the OpenRA engine here now running the Dune 2000 content. We've got Atreides campaign, Ordos campaign, and Harkonnen campaign available here. Do you have briefings? No, I don't have the briefing videos. So, yeah, I would need to find a copy of Dune 2000 to get the music and the briefings, but the game files and OpenRA content is easily available in that OpenRA package there. So again, multiplayer is available here. Doesn't look like anybody's on this playtest version yet, but this was just released today. So very cool. I'm going to have to play through this at some point. I'll see if I can't find this content available somewhere as well to get the briefings and videos and whatever came with this originally. I guess the music and the briefings. Yep. All right, we're also going to check out this map editor while we're here. Start with one of the existing maps here. So, have to learn how to use this if you want to use it, but it is available here. Modify your maps. So, it looks pretty good. We'll see what the community can build from this. Probably better tools than the original game creators had at the time. Play it right from the menu there, that's great. Music player here. Set browser. replays in here. Your credits list. The option here, classic and modern. Set your hotkeys here. All right, so that is OpenRA. As I said, it's the engine that's really the unique thing here, bringing in the game content from different sources now. We're going to keep an eye on this project and see what spawns off of this. But it's also probably one of the best ways to play the original Red Alert. The original title system playable by modern standards. There's the remakes, which had some modern features, but this is really the modern controls, modern interfaces, and everything else that you'd expect from a game, but with the classic art assets from the original titles. So that's it for this. Post below if you got any questions, and thanks for watching.